People are always asking me if I know Tyler Durden.
Three minutes. This is it. Ground zero. Would you like to say a few words to mark the occasion?
Of course I am. Can't think of anything.
For a second, I think about which CD pawn shop perhaps was the theft victim Tyler probably stole the handgun from. Oh wait, maybe we should back up. I am a cog in a system. Robot to the 9-to-5, enslaved to the designer label. Wake up, work, shop, TV, bed. I live with the greasy shine under the sun's rays. The earth a background of this restless, gloomy world of automatons. This was my life. The life of everyone and everything. Pre-destroyed paper denim jeans. Shirt hand-tailored in an insignificant Asian factory. Collar flipped up just like the magazines tell me to. Sometimes I feel like I wanted to be different. Then a new semi-annual sale pops up. My generation like pigeons to feed. Egyptian cotton, patent leather, planet Starbucks. It used to be that people read Playboy. My generation has the IKEA catalog. Business or pleasure on this trip? Why not both? So we're forlorn like children, and experienced like old men, crude and sorrowful and superficial. I believe we are lost.
The coreless insect vacuum quickly captures bugs from up to 2 feet away. Flies, bees, spiders, and other insects are suctioned by a 22,400 RPM motor, sending the insect through a one-way valve and the extension tube to an electric grid.
What a great innovation.
Sounds like something you'd buy?
Sorry, I'm more of a tissue and finger kind of guy.
Good answer.
We have the same exact glasses case.
I only use it to hold my business cards.
And this is how I met Tyler Durden.
Did you know that by mixing evil parts of gasoline and frozen orange juice concentrate, one can make napalm?
Is that true?
That's right. One can make all kinds of explosive using simple household items if one were so inclined.
Tyler, you are by far the most interesting single-serving friend I've ever met. You see, everything on a plane is single-serving.
Oh, I get it. That's clever.
Thanks.
How's that working out for you?
What?
Being clever.
It's great. Great.
Keep it up then. Right up. Now a question of etiquette. As I pass, do I give you the ass or the crotch?
And back to my job. A monkey of progress and a cubicle for the future.
The company policy claims that the most recent employee hired is the person laid off in the event of a financial crisis. By the way, that's you. Consider your employment terminated by the end of the week.
Hello?
Hi, I'm calling on behalf of the IRS. We've been looking at your records. And it seems that you've been doing a lot of spending lately. So you're being audited. Oh yeah, and by the way, you're bankrupt.
What?
And so it began. The end, or so I thought. I am Jack's irrepressible pang of loss. Desperation makes you irrational. Maybe back then I thought about all the material things I'd be losing. But now I see that I've been crushed without knowing it. I find I do not belong here anymore, a foreign world. There was my way out.
Well, man, it could be worse. You could cut off your penis while you're sleeping and throw out the window at a moving car.
There's always that. But, I don't know, it's just when you buy furniture, you tell yourself, that's it. That's the last sofa I'm ever gonna need. No matter what else happens, I've got that sofa problem handled. I had it all. I had a stereo that was very decent. Wardrobe that was getting very respectable. I was so close to being complete.
Shoot, man. Now it's all gone.
All gone.
What kind of people are we?
You know, consumers.
Right, we're consumers. We're the byproducts of a lifestyle obsession. Murder, crime, poverty. These things don't concern me. What concerns me is celebrity magazines. Television with 500 channels on them. Some guy's name on my underwear. Rogaine, Viagra, Olestra.
Martha Stewart.
Forget Martha Stewart. We are cut off from activity, from striving, progress.
I don't know, man. I've lost everything. I don't think I can handle this. What?
The things you own end up owning you. But do what you like.